Hello, my name is Ramesh Daggubati. I am the Associate Chief of Cardiology from NYU Winthrop Hospital in Long Island, New York. I'm also the Program Director for Interventional Cardiology Fellowship as well as the Director of Cardiac Cath Labs at our hospital. It's a great pleasure being at CardioAlex. Thank you.
What do you think about CardioAlex this year?
It's a fantastic meeting. I think it is the best attended meeting with nearly 7,800 physicians and residents and trainees who have come for this meeting.
Would you please tell us what are the risks of open heart surgery?
Yes. Open heart surgery is traditionally done via a sternotomy, meaning an incision in the chest wall, but nowadays robotic cardiac surgery can be done as well. So open heart meaning whether we do a sternotomy incision from about 5 inches long, and we expose the chest wall to look at the heart more carefully, and so we then attach bypass grafts. One is the internal mammary artery on the left side that is taken, and it is used as a bypass conduit to the left anterior descending artery, which is the main artery for the heart, to get blood supply. Then we take veins from the legs, and we use those as bypass conduits as well to bypass any lesion that is there in the arteries on the right side, the right coronary artery, or the artery that goes around the heart called the circumflex artery. The risks of open heart surgery are stroke. Obviously, dying itself is a big risk, and heart failure, and abnormal heart rhythms. So these are the most important risks. Death is about less than 1% chance of dying from open heart surgery. Obviously, the older the patients, the more calcified their blood vessels, and if they have lung disease from smoking, the risk of dying might go up. We have a risk calculator. In the United States, it's called the Society of Thoracic Surgeons, STS, Risk Calculator. Anybody can go on a website and bring it up and calculate their risk based on heart failure, lung functions, kidney functions, age, and whether it is first time or the second time, we can calculate their risk for dying, as well as morbidity from stroke, renal failure, and such. Stroke is less than 1% as well. Renal failure can go up to anywhere from 2 to 3%, depending upon the length of the open heart surgery. And the risk of atrial fibrillation or abnormal heart rhythm, which is irregular heartbeats, can happen even up to 25%.
Okay. Thank you for being with us at CardioAlex this year.
Thank you very much.